Can you see the screen, everyone? Can you see the screen? Am I audible? Can you see the screen and am I audible, guys? Is everything okay? Kindly comment down so I can adjust everything. So can you see the screen as full screen? Everyone? Yeah, Rohit, good evening. Where are the rest of the people? Pema is saying yes. Where are everyone? Time comes towards the mains. Now only 32 days remains before prelims, and I think 36 days remains for mains. So this is WBCS mains class. So let me wait for some 1 minute and then we will start. Okay, so I think everyone, we need to start now in order to finish the class. So first thing first, that is this is our live class, happens in every day at 5:30 p.m. live, and the cost is absolutely zero except the data cost. So this is the EduPoint app. You need to download it from Google Play Store in order to access our classes. So that's it. And next, there is a course going on, West Bengal Police. Fees is 650 monthly, and in that you will get math, reasoning, English and GK, everything under the roof of the Dronas. And you already knew the success rate of Drona in terms of West Bengal Police, so you already listened, or I think viewed the toppers class, the successful candidates class. So that only tell the success ratio of the Dronas. Okay, so first question first. So this is the first question. Which one of the following is a reptile? Which one of the following is a reptile? Is it salamander or turtle or newt or shark? What is it? Which of the following is a reptile? What will be the answer? Is it salamander or turtle or newt or shark? What will be the right answer? Reptile. So I think you guys already studied the animal kingdom part and biology, and in that you already studied the mammalia, reptilia, aves. So these things are already, I think, done to you. In that you will find several classes from fish to mammal, and in that there is reptilia, and in that there is snakes, crocodiles. These are under the part of reptilia. So right answer, as everyone say, it is A, absolutely what I say. Wrong. Salamander is not reptile, that is amphibia. What about the turtle? What about turtle, guys? What about turtle? Is the turtle is not a reptile? Isn't the turtle is a kind of reptile? Yes or no? Yes. Now the answer is coming. So Kelsang is saying B. Pema is also saying B. So now you can see the picture. Obviously the right answer is turtle. So turtle is the example, prime example of reptilia class or reptiles. Now, so this is a kind of a picture. Can you say or can you express what is it? What is this about? Anyone? In your screen you can see a picture of an animal. What is it? What is the picture is all about? And your options are like this. Your options are like this. Okay, so Kelsang is saying salamander. Emma is also saying salamander. Lizard. Rohit is saying lizard. Deep is saying A. A means salamander. No, everyone is wrong, because the picture of salamander is not so good. Not that good. Salamander is kind of a black and yellow spotted are there. So this is the picture of newt. This is the picture is all about newt. Okay, newt is a type of amphibian. It's obviously like lizard, but it's a type of a salamander, you can say, salamander family. Okay, so it's a typical picture of a newt. Moving on, question number 2. Which of the following animal possesses least number of body segments? Which of the following animal possesses least number of body segment? Least number of body segment. Is it flatworm or earthworm or prawn or cockroach? What is it? What is the right answer? What is the right answer? Is it flatworm or earthworm or prawn or cockroach? What is the right answer? What is the right answer? Anyone? So body segments means body basically classified into three or more segments. In terms of prawn and cockroach, body segments are divided into brain or head region, and then thorax, and then abdomen. In case of earthworm, it is like metamia. There are several rings in their body. So that rings are kind of called metamia. But in case of flatworm, there is nothing like it. There is nothing like it. So in this question, as everyone answered A, so that is the right answer. Except Pema. Pema is a little bit confused here. So everyone, congratulations, you already given a right answer in the difficult question. So flatworm. So can you see the picture? So this is flatworm, as you can see in your screen. So you can see there is no segments, means there is no segments here. But in case of prawn, this is prawn, Now you can clearly see this is head portion. This is thorax region. Thorax means we also have kind of thorax region in our body. So thorax means where the lung lies. Nice picture, okay. And then we have abdomen. So this is abdomen. So as Nimi is saying, nice picture. So I think Nimi is starving, and we need to give him the prawn malai curry. Now this is a picture of cockroach. Cockroach and prawn is in same phylum, that is Arthropoda, and all the arthropods kind of same. They has head portion, thorax region, and abdomen region. And then we have our earthworm. So this is the picture of earthworm. As you can see, these are the rings. So these rings is basically called metamia. Metamia. So that is it. That you need to understand in order to give the right answer in this question. Which of the following animal possesses the least number of body segment? Flatworm, no body segment. No body segment. Earthworm, many. Infinity. Prawn and cockroach, only 3. Okay, understood everyone? Everyone, do comment. And if you like this session, please like, as it is free of cost, and you can share it among the peers, so we will get motivated and will be motivated until your mains comes. And then also, if you like this session, we'll make it till your success. Now question number 3, the non-poisonous snake. The non-poisonous snake, easy one. Yeah, so everyone is saying sir. So it's the most easy question until now. So python, so python doesn't has any kind of tooth, so they just engulf it and then digest you. Okay, so right answer here is python. Now question number 4, which of the following is a polymorphic species? Which of the following is a polymorphic species? Is it garden lizard or spider or gorilla or ant? Okay, Nimi gave an answer with the logo. What is the right answer? What is the right answer, guys? Is it garden lizard or spider or gorilla or ant? What is the right answer in case you understand what is polymorphism? Now polymorphism means same genetic material but different in morphology. So that's called polymorphism. So the species that has the polymorphism or shows polymorphism is basically called polymorphic species to each other. So that's the basic funda behind this. Okay, so polymorphism means same genetic material but different color or different morphological variations. They are basically called polymorphic species. So what is the right answer? So as some are saying D, ant, and some are saying A, that means garden lizard. So for your clarification, we need to give some picture. So this is the picture. As you can see, polymorphism means these three birds, they are kind of same in genetics, but these color variations are basically called polymorphism. So as you can see in this spider, everyone has a same genetical constituents, like basic green color, but different in color. some doesn't have this antler, some has this kind of antler, and then different kind of eye-like structure, Batman-like structure. So this is a kind of Spider-Man-like structure. So you can clearly see the right answer has to be spider. But this is a kind of picture of a garden lizard. If the options are like simply lizard, then that could have been the right answer. That could have been, because lizards have also different variations. So some of you may have an irritation looking at this picture. So we are quickly moving towards the right answer. The right answer is spider. So I think everyone understand this, why the right answer is spider and why not a gorilla and ant or garden lizard. Okay, so we are moving on towards question number 5. The animal group that is not found in marine water. The animal group that is not found in marine water. Animal group that is not found in marine water. Is it mammals or amphibians or reptilian or avis? So as everyone is answering it like avis, what about seabirds? What about seabirds? What about seabirds, guys? There are several there are several seabirds out there. So not found in marine water, as the PSC says, it means the animal is not found it in the marine in like 100 meter or so. So the right answer here is amphibians. So amphibians can be found in and only in the fresh water. Fresh water. And the justification why avis is not the answer, because it's like a too simple answer. Too simple answer. You need to avoid this. The animal group that is not found. The question is not found, not live. The question doesn't say they are living there or not living there. It is only saying found. Okay, Rohit? So this is a tricks PSC always do. So the tricks here is amphibians is not not close, not a kind of close towards a saline water. They always live in a fresh water. They doesn't found in any of the sea, in any of the saline water, because their body's mechanism is such they need to live in fresh water. Doesn't salt water crocodile live in marine? Yeah, what is in it? So in case of the options are like reptiles, in case of, for example, what we have, turtle, olive ridged turtles, so they are also live in marine. So there are reptiles, mammals, you are already knew the biggest mammals, blue whale, they live in marine, they are found in marine. But in case of avis, they doesn't live in, like Rohit says, they doesn't live in marine, but they found in the marine water. They can be found in marine water. So there are different fish, there are different birds, they catches the fishes in the marine, so they found in marine and also in marine water. Some birds are catching the fish while driving towards marine water. Okay, everyone, do you understand why amphibians are the answer in case of this question? And the RTI also says that. So this is an old question. So in natural sense, obviously everyone give the answer like avis, but that is a wrong answer. Question number 6. Nerve cells originate from the embryonic. What will be the right answer? Nerve cells originate from the embryonic. What will be the right answer? Yes. So you guys, I think everyone remember the last class. In last class, we already discussed this question. Ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. So nerve cells is originate from obviously ectoderm. So that's a previous day question. So everyone give the right answer. Okay, moving on. Limbless amphibians belong to the order. So anyone knew it? Limbless amphibian. Limbless amphibian belong to the order of. So Nimi is saying Anura. For your kind information, Nimi, Anura means frog. Anura means frog. Now you have 3 options left. So let me give you the picture. So this is a good picture for your information. This is Anura. Okay, this is salamander. And this is Jimny. As this picture irritates me as well, so I need to rotate it. So Gymnophonia is the right answer. And you already seen the picture of Eurodella, that means salamander kind of thing. Anura means frog. And is you can see this is the picture of limbless amphibians. This is the picture of limbless amphibians. Okay, so right answer is C. Moving on, question number 8. It's a question of mains 2015 paper. What is the right answer? Pema is saying A and Nima is saying C. Nimi is saying echidna. Dushika is saying A. Sneha is also saying A. Everyone is saying A. What about porcupine? What is porcupine? Anyone? What is porcupine basically? What is porcupine? Anyone? What is its phylum or anything? What is porcupines? What is the Hindi name of porcupine? Sir, I have no word about the porcupine. It's a mammal. Rodents. Yeah, Nimi, it's a rodents. In Bengali, we called it Swajalu. In Hindi, it is called Sahi. Okay, so that is basically porcupine, but they also lay the young. Lay young, not they doesn't lay egg. So in this case, echidna is the right answer. But for your information, there are two animal in case of mammal. One is called platypus and another is called this is echidna. These two lay eggs. They both lay eggs. Remember this. These two organism lay eggs. Yeah. Duck-billed platypus. Yes, Pema. So, in this picture, the A option of this is platypus. Number B is echidna. And number C is their egg-laying property. So, the right answer in this case is obviously echidna. Kangaroo also lay young and they are called marsupials. Kangaroo is basically called marsupials. And porcupine is like rodents. And whale, you know already, that is porcupine is kind of a rat-like animal. Okay, and they are not like fully these features, this putative features is not fully developed in case of porcupine, but in case of echidna it is fully developed. They are kind of look alike animal, you can say. Okay, now question number 9. In portion of the size of the body, which birds lay largest size eggs? As you can say, this is a question of mains, but I think you people still confused or still make the mistake as it's a tricky question. In portion of size of the body, which birds lay largest size egg? Am I saying 9D? Kiwi Tinamons. Mimi is saying Tinamons. Tinamons, what is the Tinamons? What is Tinamons, Mimi? What is Tinamons? Is any animal belongs to Tinamons? What is Tinamons, Nimi? Nimi gave the answer, Tinamons. What is Tinamons, Nimi? What is Tinamons? So no answer till now. So Tinamo is a kind of bird, Tinamo family, and in that it can be found in the American continent. But for my consensus, everyone gave the right answer, and the right answer is Kiwi. You all people already make an impact, and everyone says the right answer. I thought everyone gave ostrich as an answer, but no one gave ostrich as an answer. Everyone gave kiwi as an answer. So this is the kind of picture in case of kiwi and in case of ostrich. So as you can see, the egg of the ostrich is the biggest egg, or you can say biggest cell in the animal. But the portion of the body and the egg, as you can see, it's kind of very small. But in case of kiwi, the portion of the egg and their body size is kind of huge. So they contain huge egg in terms of or in comparison to their body size. So that's why QV is the right answer, because QV's body size is very small, but their egg size is very large in compared to their body size. Okay, so question number 10. Study of the bird's nest is called what is it called? Study of the bird's nest. Is it ornithology or nidology or phenology or ecology? What will be the right answer? What will be the right answer? What will be the right answer? So this is a kind of question like one word substitution, but here also the thing can come. So some are saying ornithology, some are saying nidology as the answer. So those of you giving B as the answer, you are absolutely correct. Nidology is basically the study of bird's nest, and ornithology is called as study of birds, not their nest, only the birds. So study of birds is called ornithology, but their nest is called nidology. So right answer is nidology. Then what is phenology? As you already knew, what is ecology? Ecology is basically the interaction between the organism is basically called ecology, and the Professor Ernst Haeckel is responsible here. Now this is phenology. Phenology basically means, according to the World Book of Encyclopedia, phenology is the study of when certain biological events that depend on climate take place. So phenology is kind of dependent on climatology. So as climate changes, if the biological events occurs, then that is called phenology. So like leaves changing colors in autumns. Basically in autumn, the deciduous plant, they changes their color, and they also after that falling from the tree. Birds migrates in from winter to the tropological area. Like in case of West Bengal, there are several lakes that are very famous for migratory bird species and plant sprouting. So as the clear climate, if there, then the plant sprouts. Okay, and here there is some animal, and then there is some hormones that is responsible for here, that is called abscisic acid. Abscisic acid basically responsible here when the correct environment is there for the plant to sprout. Now question number 11. Salmon fishes are also called bony fish, trout, cod or starfish. Bony fish, trout, cod or starfish. Salmon fishes are also called. What is the right answer? So Pema and Nimi only gave the answer. What is the right answer? Please do like this session, and if possible share it were kind of in need for this kind of preparation and create an environment like healthy competition among your peers, so that you also get motivated and they also give you the egoistic boost, because ego is directly connected to strength. So Kelsang is saying B, Pramila is saying C, Shankar is saying codfish, Pema is saying C. And rest of the people, what is the answer? So for your information, you can see these two picture. One is the picture of a salamander type and another is the picture of cod. So as you can see, this is the picture of a cod and this is the picture of a trout, and trout is basically a type of salamander. Okay, so right answer here is trout. Okay, so the right answer is trout. Trout. Okay, yes, Nimi is absolutely right. Now, animal with a single nostril is. Animal with a single nostril is. Whale, tortoise, python, or shark. What is the right answer? Animal with a single nostril. So, Shankar already gave. Shankar is saying A, Kelsang is saying A, Pema is also saying A, Nimi is saying turtle. So, you can clearly see in your picture, Nimi, a turtle also has two nostrils. As we have two nostrils, turtle is also having two nostrils, not one. So, you can clearly see this picture. So, this is a particular picture of a whale. And here there is one nostril. Okay. So, as you clearly see. Yeah. So, Kelsang is giving you your kind of answer with the emojis. So right answer is well. Well is the right answer. Nimi, your emoji doesn't contain the nostril busting. Question number 13. Equus caballus is the scientific name of. Equus caballus is the scientific name of. Is it cow or horse or cat or tiger? So Nimi is saying horse with two loves, and rest of the people is saying only option B. Arpan. So, after a long time, I can see you, Arpan. Right answer is obviously, everyone is absolutely right, B, horse. As only the genus name can suggest, equus is a kind of a horse, not cow or cat or tiger. What is the scientific name of cat? What is the scientific name of tiger? And what is the scientific name of cow? Anyone? What is the scientific name of cow? First, as cow is the animal that is gaining some political attention. So what is the scientific name of cow? So let me help you. The genus name starts with boss. So as the genus is saying, cow is the boss. So what is the species name? What is the species name? Yeah. Nimi is saying boss. It is not B-O-S-S. It is not B-O-S-S. It is B-O-S. So BOS, TAU, Taurus, or Domesticus, whatever you can say, there are different species. Horse is equals, cat is Felis indica or Felis catus. You can say Felis catus. And obviously the scientific name of tiger is Panthera leo. Panthera, not leo, tigris. Panthera leo is the scientific name of lion. Yeah. So moving on, question number 14. Young cockroach is called is it Ephyra or nymph or maggot or juvenile? So we already discussed this question. So it's a kind of remember or revision for you. So Shankar is saying B, Liang is saying B. So everyone is saying B, 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 B. Arpan is also saying B. Yes, the right answer B. You all remember this question. So right answer nymph. We already gave the picture in the previous, I think, practice session 2 or 3. We already have this question, so no need to discuss. Question number 15. The control center of a cell is? So for the new people, there is an announcement. If you want to find the PDF, you can get the PDF by joining the Telegram channel. Okay, so in the description you will find the link of the Telegram channel, and you can join and you can have this PDF of the practice session. So Pema is saying nucleus with a smiley. Yes, who discovered nucleus, Pema? Pema and Nimi, who discovered nucleus? Shankar, the control center of a cell basically nucleus. In nucleus there is nuclear reticulum, and in reticulum there is basically chromosome, and in chromosome basically there is DNA, and in DNA there is basically gene, but that is not the answer. Okay, so basically if the question comes who is responsible for hereditary character, then the answer can be genes or DNA or chromosome. So this is a particular orientation of the question. According to that, the answer will be taken. So nucleus here is the answer, and the Robert Brown discovered nucleus in 1931, I think, or 1831, I don't remember the year. Moving on, question number 16. Skin, ears and kidney are the example of. Skin, ears and kidney are the example of organ system or organs of tissue or cell. Skin, ears and kidney are the example of. So Bijayita, after a long time I see your name, Bijayita, saying B, Nimi is saying organ, Nima is saying C, Kelsang is saying B. Who are saying C? Nima. Rohit is also saying A or B. Rohit, system means digestive system, endocrine system, reproductive system, or nervous system, or excretory system. These are kind of system. System, so there is basic difference between this. When the cells functions, when the cumulative cells function similar, then that is called tissue. When the tissue, cumulative tissue functions similar, then that is called organ. And the when organ functions similar, then that is called system. System means digestive, excretory, muscle system. So basically their system. Organs means these are kind of organs. Skin is our largest organ. Yeah, kidney. Kidney is the organ of the excretory system. This system. Kidney is a part of this. So basically they are all the type of system. Sensory and excretory system both are there. That's why, sir. Sensory, okay. Nervous system, they are doing the balancing thing and all that. So basically here the right answer will be organs. Organs, they particularly a kind of organ. Individually they are organ. Moving on. Question number 17. The system removes waste product from the body. the system removes waste product from the body. Is it integumentary or excretory or digestive or all of the above? So only Pamela gave the answer. Kelsang, Soikot, Giri. Welcome, Soikot Giri. I think you are new here. So if you are new, then in the description box, there is a link for this session. You will join the Telegram and you will get the PDF. And if you are liking this session, kindly like it and share among the peers in order to bring the competition here so that the fight results into the success. So everyone is saying excretory. Yes, right answer is excretory, because waste is basically removes by the kidney, and the urination removes through the urethra of the body. Question number 18. The bottom of the heart is called. So let me check your preparation in circulatory system. So only Rohit gave the answer. Everyone, the bottom of the heart. Nima is saying ventricle. Nimi is saying atrium. Vijayita is saying ventricle. Pema is saying ventricle. Pramila is saying atrium. So Nimi is saying bottom ventricle. So I think all of you gave the answer. Where is Shankar? And where is Soikot Giri? Soikot Giri, tumi jodi paro to answer dao. Kelsang is saying A, ventricle. Rishika Thapa is saying D, aorta. So Rishika first gave the different answer, except A and B. Soikot bolche A. So let me give you a picture and the answer will change. The bottom part, as you can see, so this is aorta, the option number D, I think. This is right atrium and left atrium, and then there is left ventricle and right ventricle, and here is septum. Here is septum. So moving on to the question. Is it ventricle? Yes or no? The bottom part of the heart. So they are saying bottom part. So is it ventricle? No. Is it aorta? Doesn't seem to be. Is it atrium? No. So right answer will be this part, the bottom part, is basically called septum. Septum. Okay, is your doubt clear? Is there any doubt right now? Septum is situated middle. Septum is situated middle. So what is the bottom part? If septum is separated left and right ventricle, and it is already in the bottom area of the heart, and what will be the right answer? Septum doesn't mean only this portion, not this. Yeah, that middle portion and also the this portion, na? Okay. So right answer here is septum, bottom of the heart. Now, in which structure is blood filtered within the kidney? In which structure is blood filtered with kidney? in which structure is blood filtered with kidney? What is the right answer? So everyone is saying nephron, ureter. Shankar is saying ureter. Vijayita is saying D. Nimi is saying glomerular filtration with again a emoji. So which structure is blood filtered within the kidney? So in the kidney, basically there is nephron. And here is the answer is nephron, not ureter or gland or bladder. So as you can see, so unified blood enters in the kidney from this red thing and then go on, and there is nephron, and in nephron, as Nimi is saying, glomerular filtration. So basically in that there is Bowman's capsules, and then there is glomerulus, and then there is filtration. We already give an idea of juxtaglomerular apparatus, I think, JCA apparatus. So they already suggest what the pressure of the blood should be in order to filter this blood. So nephron is basically, or the juxtaglomerular apparatus along with Bowman's capsule and glomerulus, they already responsible for filtration. Ureter is this portion, okay, that is the filtered part moving on by the ureter, and then they comes down towards the bladder, and then through urethra you are urinating, okay. So that's in between the penis, so that is basically urethra. So in this case, ureter, gland, bladder, none is the right answer. Right answer is nephron. Moving on, question number 20. DAS makes urea and breaks down old red blood cells. Which organ basically breaks down RBC as well as urea cycle happens there? Anita is saying, Nimi is already given the answer, liver with the three lobes. Nima, Nimi, Pramila, Shubhekcha saying D. Nimi is saying ornithine cycle. Okay. Shankar is saying kidney. Arpan is saying D. Vijayita Chetri is saying D. Rishika Thapa is saying D. So I'm urging everyone, if you like this session, kindly like it. Is it absolutely zero cost? So we will be motivated as always. So the right answer here is liver. So as you can see in this picture, so red blood cells, in that hemoglobins and in that heme, makes bilirubin and biliverdin. This goes down to kidney and then urobilirubin excreted. So this is the pathway. Okay. This is the pathway of red blood cells, and from it the bilirubin. And for the urea cycle, the liver, and in liver there is mitochondria. Remember this. Mitochondria is the area where urea cycle happens, not in the cytoplasm of the liver. They give ammonia as a waste nitrogen, and then first thing citrulline and then there is a cycle that is called urea cycle or ornithine cycle, as Nimi said. So Nimi is getting some brownie point here by giving ornithine cycle, or the name of the ornithine cycle here. So from ornithine, the last product is urea, and that goes with the bloodstream, and then filtration happens. And our basic product of our excretion is basically urea, and that's why we are called ureotelic. And whoever excrete uric acid, they are called ureotelic. So that's basically birds. And whoever excrete ammonia as a excretory waste, like fish, they are called amniotelic. So amniotelic is the most dangerous excretory material. And then we have our urea, that is lesser, and the least one is ureotelic in case of birds. Okay. Biology is like very tough for you. Please read this book, Lucent's Yellow Book. First read this book and then move on to NCERT or anything else. First read this book, Lucent's Yellow Book. In that, there is a science section, particularly physics, chemistry and biology, and everything is kind of good in that book, except economics and to some extent polity. This too is not well written in that book. Out of history, geography, and then biology, physics, chemistry, and also the GK portion, the static GK, that also good in that book. Just read that. There is everything written in a particular smaller format. So they wrote it in a concise manner, so it is difficult for you to understand. And for that, you need to Google it to give the picture. And then you will understand everything in case of biology. So moving on, question number 21. The central nervous system includes. Today only, if you have this yellow book, Lucent's Yellow Book, open the biology section, and in that there is nervous system. And then nervous system, you will find this central nervous system. So Nimi already said the answer, brain and spinal cord. So Nimi today is in the form, as well as Kelsang, Sneha, Pramila, Brijileta, Sankar, Anita, Nima, Rohit. Everyone is saying D. Yes. So in last class, we already studied central nervous system, PNS and ANS. What is the full form of PNS? In the last class, we already studied this PNS and ANS. What is the full form of these two, PNS and ANS? What is the full form of PNS and ANS? Yes. PEMA, peripheral, Nimi peripheral, and again PEMA, autonomous nervous system. Yes. So these are the three types of nervous system we have. Now moving on, question number 22. The part of the brain responsible for thinking and memory. We already gave the picture of it in the last class. That is, there are four lobes. Temporal lobe, frontal lobe, occipital lobe, and everything is in the cerebrum. Yes, everyone gave the right answer. Absolutely. Absolutely good. Absolutely fantabulous, fantastic. So you are giving me the worth of teaching you, that is everyone listening what I am saying, that is cerebrum is the right answer here. In the cerebrum, what their main function is thinking, touching, listening, and also visual effect, everything is in cerebrum. In cerebrum, basically the balancing. Medulla is basically doing the inner junction between the spinal cord and the brain. So you can clearly see this is the part of cerebrum, and in that there is frontal lobe, basically thinking. Frontal lobe basically responsible for thinking. Yes, Sneha and Yoga. Sneha, yes, B is the right answer. So this is the typical function of sensory cortex, parietal lobe, occipital basically vision, and temporal basically memory, understanding and language, and also listening. Yeah. Now what is the right answer for question number 23? The endocrine gland that helps regulate blood glucose level. Shankar, sir, is it possible for a non-science background student to perform a better score? So in WBCS, there is total 800 in MCQ paper. Paper 1 consists of history and geography. That is for non-science. Paper 2, in case of, that is whatever called paper 3 and paper 4, whatever you can say, that is science plus GK plus current affairs. So total 200. In terms of science, basically biology consists of 20 to 30 questions, and rest 180 question comes from 180 to 170 comes from GK and current affairs, as well as physics and everything. Paper 3 or paper 5, that is constitution plus economics, that is also part of non-science. Paper 6, that consists of math and reasoning. So you can clearly see out of this 800, science contains only 50 to 60. Only 50 to 60, Shankar. So it's not that you never or you are afraid of. So the comparison give you the idea that you are in a right track. Rishika is saying, Sneha is saying option A, Shankar is saying thyroid, not thyroid, because pancreas, islets of Langerhans, beta cells, excellent, secret insulin, excellent new, beta cells, islets of Langerhans produce insulin, excellent, Pema, yogurt, yes, right answer A. This insulin regulate our body glucose. So as you guys can see, the answer of Nimu and Pema, they're giving the explanation as well. So pancreas is responsible for making regulation of blood glucose level, as the glucose basically transfer to body as glycogen by the insulin that secretes from beta cells of islets of Langerhans, and that is antagonistically regulated by glucagon, another hormone secreted by pancreas as well. Glycogen to glucose is glucagon. Yes, Nemo is absolutely in the form like what we can say, like Rohit Sharma or recently that chap, Bhadar or something. Okay, question number 24. The endocrine organ controls changes in a male's body and regulates the production of sperm. Sukhecha, you are making little wrong because you overlook the options. In the option, there is a particular options. So ignoring that option, you are giving the importance to some gland that secretes some androgen or something. Yes. C. Yes. When the options is testes, you no need to look around. No need to look here and there, because testes is the master gland for maleness. Why? Because endocrine organ that controls the changes in a male's body, because in testes the testosterone secreted, and that testosterone is responsible for production of sperm. Yes, adrenal also responsible by secreting androgen from adrenal cortex, but when testis is there, everyone faded away. So the right answer is testis. So yoga is saying pituitary. Yes, pituitary is also responsible to control male's body, but to some extent, because in pituitary there is gonadotropic hormone, and then gonadotropic hormone is already giving the effect of testis, and in testis there is seminiferous tubule. Seminiferous tubule that is basically responsible to secrete sperm. So when testis is there, testis will be the answer. Last question for today. What is the term which describes the time an egg is released from an ovary? What is the right answer? So as everyone saying, what is the right answer? So we can quickly make So already everyone is the right answer. So here the right answer is yes. Hello everyone. That's why I at the end we are interacting. So the right answer is ovulation. Yes. So after ovulation, there will be fertilization when the sperm mixed with the ovum. At the time ovulation happens, and after ovulation there will be reproduction, means the delivery of the child. Okay, so that's it for everyone. So what is it? Give your response. So if you are liking this session, please like it and please share it. Yes, Nimi, thank you. Rohit, thank you. Pramila, thank you. Everyone, thank you. And we'll meet on our next day, that is Friday. Sneha, thank you. We are in our class here. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day or good night. And hope you are preparing it right. I'm ending my session here.